In this video, let us try to understand how to basically connect to a Linux machine using a terminal. So, to create a Linux machine, you will be seeing two videos on the screen at this moment, which will help you on how to create a Linux machine either in AWS or in Azure. So, now let us try to see how do I connect to a Linux machine from my Windows server. As we have discussed in the previous video, for that we need to have a terminal, and I'll be showing how to connect to a terminal in Git Bash, also with PowerShell in this video. And please note, you will be able to do it from PowerShell only when you are on a latest version of Windows 10. So let us get started. Building the command for connecting to a Linux machine is very simple. The command is SSH, which stands for secure shell, username @ IP address. Whenever you execute this command, it will ask you for password. Now, let us try to build this command. SSH, my username is devops, at IP address, which is 18.237.72.233. So when you create a machine, you might have your own IP address. Isn't it simple to just construct this SSH command? Now copy this command, go into your terminal, and then paste this command. It asks for a password. Enter the password, and you are connected to a shell prompt of the Linux machine on the cloud. If you want to come out of it, just execute a very simple command, which is called as exit. Now let us try to do the same thing on a Git Bash. So I am pasting again the command. I click on enter. It would ask me for password. I enter the password. I'm in. And over here, just like in the last video, let us enter some commands. It is showing me date. It will show me calendar. Okay. It will show me present working directory. And now I am done. If I am done with my terminal, I'll exit. So I think this video will be helpful for you to understand how to connect to your machine. And let me speak about one more scenario. So all the Linux machines might not have passwords. They might have keys. So let us assume that I have a key file. Okay. Rather than a password now, and that key file is present in my C drive, users, whatever your username is, right? So let us see what is my username. So it is Learning Thoughts, and in this, in downloads folder, if I have a file which is called as something like linux.pim. So generally you will see these kind of keys downloaded whenever you are creating machines in AWS. Even in that case, your life should not be very difficult. It is very simple. SSH -i path to key file, okay. I think I'll do one thing, I'll increase the font of it. So let me make it at 18. Yes. And username @ IP address. Now my command might look something like ssh-i. Okay. The home directory can be substituted by using this tilde symbol /downloads/linux.vim. If you want, you can put hyphens around and then username. The username in my case is DevOps and IP address in my case is 18.237.72.233. Now you have to just copy this command and paste it in your PowerShell, right? And if you are doing it in Git Bash, there will be a slight change, okay? So because Git Bash gives you a little bit of Linux kind of paths, just replace this backward slashes with forward slashes. That's it. So whether you have a key or whether you have a password, connecting to a Linux machine from your Windows laptop is as simple as this. I think this video was helpful and this should help you to connect to the machines which you have been creating in cloud or even in your local machines as virtual machines. Thanks for your time.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.